Good morning, everyone gathered here. It's an immense pleasure in welcoming you all to this hands-on session on Core Java and interview perspective. First, I would like to welcome our chairperson, Dr. Nani Selvaraj, our director, Mr. Amar Raj, and our Millard principal, Dr. John Oral Baskar. Next, I would like to welcome our today's chief guest, Mr. Arun Raju, who is working as an assistant vice president in City Corp Limited. He also been a full stack developer, an ethical hacker, a trainer, a digital marketing specialist, and a data scientist. We welcome you, sir. Next, I would like to welcome our head of the department, Dr. P. Shantakumar, our convener, Ms. T. E. Martina Jensi, Assistant Professor of IT Department, and our Event Coordinator, Ms. R. Bhavani, Assistant Professor of IT Department. Last but not the least, I'm also excited in welcoming all my friends to this event. Once again, I welcome all to this one-day event. Thank you. Now we can start the session, sir.
Okay. Hi. Thank you for your invitation. And can you all able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we will start. Okay. I'll be sharing my screen. So now you are able to see my screen, right? Can you all able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today's topic we'll be discussing is on Core Java. So let me open the presentation. So today's topic is about Core Java. Okay, so I'll be focusing on hands-on session, like how the interviewer will ask, like what are all the questions they will ask for a fresher, and how we have to answer. And I will explain everything in hands-on, like I will do a small coding of each and every concept so that you can able to understand. Like before that, I want to ask you, like which year are there, like is that third year or final year? You can type in chat in that. Can you tell me, like, who are the participants? Is that like third year or final year?
All third the year, 3 years.
Okay, fine. So I think you have a subject, right? Like Java or internet programming. Do you have a subject called subject that contains Java content in third year? What is that? What are the contents you are learning in that course for third year, or is it for final year? What is the subject name you are learning? So, is there any subject which is related to Java in your course for third year or final year? Okay. So, So we'll see how to face an interview. And what are all the repeated Java questions they will ask? How we should answer like that? Okay. So when you enter into an interview, okay, the first question they will ask, like tell about yourself and where are you from? What is your degree? Like that they will ask. Okay. And regarding that technical round, the major question they will ask is like, what is your favorite language and why? Okay. So I will be sharing one link. Okay, so all the students are requested to type in why what is your favorite language and why it is. Okay, so I'll be sharing a link. Okay, so you have to type in the response, and once the response is submitted, I will get all the response from my end. So you don't need to type your name here, you can just type the response. For example, here my question is like, what is your favorite language and why? So we can make this session to be much interactive. Okay. So I have I've just pasted the URL in the chat. You just click that and you just answer it. I just want to know, like, what is the favorite language for all the students, and what is like, what is the reason behind it? That is the only thing. You can type anything. If you know C, you can type C, and what is the reason for that? Like, you can type anything. So do it now. Like, I will give 2 minutes. You can type. No need to type your name. Okay. And after each and every topic, like, I will ask a question. So you have to type in the answer. And at last, I will give you some list of questions. You have to type in the answer with your name. Okay. So the first five students who gave the correct answer will get a small gift from me. Okay. So now type, what is your favorite language and why it is a favorite language? So you just click that link and you just respond the answer. So I have received only from one student. Others, please type your responses. Okay, so first one is Python, and it is easy for coding. The second one is, I like HTML language because it is easy and interactive. Okay, Java. Another one, Python, because it's easy to understand. Okay, again Python. HTML, CSS, it's easy for web design development. Okay. Okay, Java, because it's Hoops concept, platform independent. Okay. Okay, easy to learn. So C, then again HTML, CSS. Okay, so I think that's enough. Like, okay, so most of you have given Python. And some of you have given Java, and some of you have given HTML, CSS, and only one student has given C program. Okay. So I just want to know, like, what is your area of interest and why it is like that. Okay. Most of the people have given Python and Java. So now what we will do is, so we'll go directly into the session. Okay. So what is your favorite language and why? Suppose if you know about Java, so if you are going for an interview with your skill set Java, okay, what is your favorite language and why? So what you have to answer is, Java is my favorite language because anywhere, like everywhere Java is used, like if you have like 100 companies, 80 companies, they are using Java technology because Java is a free open source. Okay. And also Java has plenty of functionalities, like it has application oriented projects, and it has web development, and it has many other things. Okay, just like that, you can tell, like, my Java is my favorite language, and because it's an open source and it is platform independent. So we'll come across all the concepts. Okay, so this will be the first main question they will ask in the interview. Okay, so now the second one is, why Java is platform independent? Okay, so anyone knows why Java is platform independent? Can you type in why Java is platform independent? After your answer, I will explain what is the answer for this. So you can type in the same in the same link, okay, and tell me why Java is platform independent. Why C++ is not platform independent? So just type in your answer. Like, I just want some 2 or 3 people to type in, then later we will go for the answer. So why Java is platform independent and why C++ is platform dependent, and what is mean by platform independent and why it is platform dependent? Can type in the same link and you just response the answer. Okay, so I got on response like it does not depend on any platform. Okay, that's correct. Okay, it does not depend on other language, so it is platform independent. That is also okay. Okay, fine, that's enough. Like we have like limited amount of time. Okay, you can stop typing. Okay, so what I will do is I will just tell you why Java is platform independent. Okay, so with practical example, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to run one program. Okay, say I'm going to create a Java folder here, and I'm going to type in one Java program here. So I'm going to type in a Java program here, and I'm going to show why it is platform independent. So just like that, I will type a class. So because Java is class oriented, so I'll be first typing a class followed by class name, then the main method. This is the main method of Java. In C++, it is like void main. In C also, it is like void main. And to print something, I will be using system.out.println. Say like that. Okay, I just completed very small application. Okay, so by running this application, I will tell you why Java is platform independent. Okay, so now what I have done is like I have done I just opened one Java file. Okay, so Java file is hello.java and the source file name is .java. Now I'm going to compile it. Okay, so for compiling I need to set a path. Okay, so I think you already know about setting the path, right? So first I will check for program files whether Java is there, and I will take the bin component. I will copy that and I will go to my PC properties. So environment variable I will do, then in path I will type in this location of Java including bin. Then I will type in, I will just search in the CMD. Okay. So now I just executed a very small application. So I'm going to just run this program. So to run this program, it is Java C space, hello.java. So interview, they will ask also like, how will you compile a Java program? Like I have hello.java in my application. So I have hello.java in my application. Okay. So now when you compile it, what you can see is you can see hello.class. Okay. So what is this hello and what is this hello.class? Hello.java is nothing but it's like written in a human readable format. Okay, it's said to be a source code, and when you compile it, how will you compile it? We can use Java C space file name dot Java. When you compile it, what you will get is a class file. Okay, so hello dot class. So what I can do is, suppose this is my operating system which is running in Windows. Okay, Windows 10. Suppose what I will do is I can copy this class file and I can run it in any other operating system. Say I want to run in Linux, okay, or say I want to run in Macintosh OS, okay. So what I can do is I don't need to compile each and every time. I can just copy this class file and I can just run in, I can just paste it in their other operating system, and I can just run it directly with the help of the command called Java space hello. Okay, and you'll get the result. So the concept is very simple. Why Java is platform independent? We can just take up the class file and we can run in any operating system. Okay, so no need to compile each and every time. So you can just compile once and you can run many. So that is concept of a platform independent. So it is compile once, run many, or in other words, we can call it as WORM. Write once and run many. So I can run write only one, and I can just compile it. I can take a class file and I can run it in any operating system. So that is all about platform independent. Okay, and what is platform dependent? So C and C++ are platform dependent, because if you want to run a C program which is written in Windows, if you want to run it in Linux, you need to compile that C program again in Linux. Okay, so then only you can able to run that in another operating system. But in Java, you can write only once and you can run at many operating system or at any operating system. So who will take care why it is running in many operating system? The reason is JVM, Java Virtual Machine. So Java Virtual Machine is common for all the operating system. Because of this functionality, we can able to run a class file in any operating system. Okay, so this is very important question. They will ask, okay, so your area of interest is Java. Can you tell me why Java is platform independent like that? Okay, your immediate answer should be Java is platform independent because it can be supported in any operating system. You can run a Java program in any operating system and through the concept of write once and run many. So write once means like you can write an application, you can just compile it and you can take a class file and you can run it in any application. Okay, and JVM, how this platform independent happens? Because of JVM. So JVM is nothing but Java Virtual Machine, which can able to perform this platform independent. Okay, so any doubt in this question, because it's a very important question. Okay, so can you type in your can you just type in your doubt if you have in the chat, in the same link or in a chat also. So is it okay? Can you all answer why Java is platform independent? You can able to answer no now in interview. You can just type in your response you are able to understand or you are not able to understand like that. Okay, can you just type in? Maybe two or three people, can you please type in whether you are able to understand why Java is platform independent? Okay, fine. So now what we will do is we'll move on to the next question. Features of Java. Okay, so the features of Java, they will ask, okay, because you are a fresher, okay, they will ask very small questions, simple questions only. Features of Java. Okay, so features of Java, it's first feature is platform independent. You can say it is open source, you can say, and you can say it is free to download and free to distribute and all. Then you can say it is secured. I will tell you why Java is secured with a very, very good, interesting concept. Okay. And Java is distributed. Okay. So I'm giving a session in a Google Meet now. Okay. So it's a distributed application. I can able to deliver my content through remote. That is distributed. So similar to this, we can able to create any distributed application with the help of Java. For example, our server socket application, okay, our servlet application. So those applications are distributed. Then robust is another one. And the important thing is object-oriented, and portable. Java can able to run in any operating system. For example, Java can be used in mobiles. Java can be used in embedded system. And many things you can say, and it is very simple and it is very easy to use. That is the feature. You can add any feature like Java is easy to use or Java is very portable, like that. You can add any any point in them. So this is the second one. They will ask, what is the feature of Java like that? Okay, so this should be your answer. And next question is, they will ask, can you explain what is the basic structure of Java? That we already saw. Okay, so basic structure of Java is this. So Java is like it is a class oriented programming language. So everything in Java is a class. So you can see class followed by class name. Okay, and the main method of Java is public static void main. Okay, so it is similar to in C we have like void main, or in C++ you have a int main like that. So in Java also it is like public static void main. I will explain you what is static keyword and what is this parameter and all. And if you want to print something in Java, you have to use system.out.println. Again, this also I will explain you in a very detailed manner. Just for now, you can just say like, this is the structure. Like every Java program has a class. And if the class is said to be a main program, then it should have a public static void main. Like that you can see. Okay. So this is a beginner question. Like mostly they won't ask this question, but this is the beginner question. I will explain all other things like static and everything in the upcoming hours maybe. Okay, then a very important and also like many people doesn't know about this answer, like what is the magic number of Java? Can anyone tell me what is the magic number of Java? You can just type in the chat. Can anyone tell me what is the magic number of Java? I will explain you after. Suppose you can type wrong also, it's not an issue. Just type whatever comes in your mind, you can type. What is the magic number of Java? Just click that link and tell. Just give me your answers. So we'll take a minute. Just give me your answers in the Google form. So what is the magic number of Java? You can search in internet also. You can't able to find this answer, I'm sure. Okay, so one person I have given like 19. Just give me like whatever answer. What about others? Like, can you just give at least I want some 4 or 5 people to type in. Yeah, teachers can also type in them. What is magic number of Java? Because I could say like in my company also, like under me, like many people are there. Okay, 64 or 65 people are there. So out of 65, like roughly like 2 or 3 people know this answer. Okay, so thanks for your response. Okay, so now we will see what is the magic number of Java. So like I said, when you compile a Java program, you will get a hello.class, right? So anyone have tried opening this hello.java? So I'm going to open it with Notepad. Okay. Anyone have tried with opening this hello.class? So when you open this hello.class, you could see this is the byte code. Okay. So when you compile anything, any Java, you will get a .class file. That is otherwise called as a bytecode. And when you see the first one, okay, when you see the first character, maximize it. When you see the first character, it will be like this. So I'm saying this is magic number of Java. Okay. So whenever you compile any Java program, you will get a .class file. So whatever Java program, whether it may be a small application or whether it may be a web application, the first 4 character of the class file is magic number. Okay. So I'm telling you it is magic number, but where is the number? Okay, I'm going to explain this. So these are the ASCII values. Okay, so now I'm going to convert this into a hexadecimal language. I'm just going to open this thing and I'm going to type in ASCII to hexadecimal converter. So I'm going to just paste in this ASCII and I'm going to convert it. Okay, now you can see the response cave babe. Okay, so I'm going to paste it here. Now this is the magic number of Java. Okay, so this is cave babe. Okay, it is cave babe and this is hexadecimal number. So you can say CA is one hexadecimal number, FE is another one, BA is another one, and BE is another one. So magic number of Java is kfbabe. And why they have given this kfbabe as a magic number? Anyone knows why they have given this magic number kfbabe? Why can't they can give like other hexadecimal numbers? So there is a small story of it. Okay, so in Java, like the persons like who developed the Java, they want to have high security within Java. What they did is like they want to put some signature. So this is some signature in class file. They want to put some signature. Okay, they tried with many signature, many ASCII characters, but they were not able to identify it. So with the frustration, they went to a coffee shop. Okay. Normally, you know, right, that initial name of Java is Oak and later it is converted to Java, right? So Java is nothing but a coffee bean. Okay. So for kfbabe, for magic number of Java, they got frustrated. They went to a coffee shop. Okay. Normally in coffee shop, in that time in their country, in coffee shop, there will be a girl who sings a song like with a guitar and a music instrument. People will call her like a cave babe. Okay, so with that cave babe, this is coming into their idea. Like the person who developed Java, they were able to see why can't we put a cave babe in our Java like that. So they converted this cave babe because you can see it is satisfying hexadecimal. You see. Hexadecimal is nothing but 0 to E, right? So it is like C is there, hexadecimal, A is there, F is there, everything is there. So they just took this hexadecimal number, okay, and they just convert into the ASCII value and they just integrated that into the class file. So this is how the magic number of Java comes. Okay, it has a very interesting story also. Okay, so if someone in interview, if they ask what is magic number, you can tell the story. Okay, so what is magic number of Java? Can you all type in your response? What is the magic number of Java? I just now told you, no? What is the magic number of Java? You can just type in. Okay, it's kfbabe. You can ask this question to anyone. Okay, like you can ask to any people, like any other people or any other, like you are IT, right? So you can ask a computer science engineering student, you can ask to any people, like they doesn't know about this. Okay, you just try to convey this thing. Okay, Java, what is magic number of Java? Okay, so what is the use? Okay, one interesting question, what is the use of magic number? Okay, like I said, they integrated magic number, right? So I will tell you. So to provide a security, no. For example, sometime what happens is like hacker will able to access this class file and they can able to change the content. For example, these are the bytecode format. They can able to change the content. So to avoid that, for every Java, like they have this magic number. They have this ASCII, so which can't be modified. Okay, if someone modifies, suppose if I try to modify this thing, no, what will happen is when you run this Java program, first it will check for magic number. If there is no magic number, then the Java won't run actually. Okay, if you try to modify a class file, what will happen is this magic number will tell you like this Java file is corrupted or this Java file is getting hacked. So that is the reason they have added this magic number. Okay, and that is also comes to the concept of secure. You can say Java is secured because of its magic number. Okay, any doubt? Any doubt in your question? Have I answered this? What is the use of magic number? You can just make Java to secure. We can use this magic number. Okay, so we'll just go fast because it just took many like plenty of time in answering 4 questions. Okay. Then next 2 question is what is encapsulation? Okay, so this is another OOPS concept, encapsulation. Okay, I will try to explain with a code. So I'm not going to type it in Notepad. So hereafter I will just use Eclipse. Okay, so because it will just we can execute faster. I just open Eclipse. So the version is Oxygen. I will just open a fresh Eclipse. Then I will explain each and every concept. Okay, here. Then I will, at the end of the session, I will share you this code. So I will just go to file. Okay. File other, I can select Java application, Java project. I can give the file name or project name. Thanks. So as a beginner, you just try to run the Java program in Notepad, then you can go for Eclipse. Okay, so then I will create a package. Package is nothing but a way of organizing. Okay, it's like way of organizing the code. Okay, first I'm going to show encapsulation. So I will just type in the package name. Normally package name will be the reverse of the domain name. Okay, I think your college is like kingcdu.org, right? So we can write org.kingcdu.ncapsulation like that. So first I have created a package. Now I will show you what is encapsulation. So I will create a class called ENC demo. So that is encapsulation demo. And I will put a public static void main method. Okay, so this is the another like structure of Java. Okay, so this class, whenever you create any class, okay, then that class is said to be encapsulated. So that means every class in Java file is said to be an encapsulation. Okay, for example, I can create some variable here like string name int age, like that I can create any variable here. Okay, and also I can create any method. So say it is like getters or setters method for this age. Okay, so this is the class. And you have 2 variables, name and age. Name is string and age is integer. And you have a method to get this name and set this name. Okay. So this whole class is said to be encapsulated. Okay. Encapsulation is nothing but the process of, okay, having data member and member method. So this is data member. Okay. Name and age are said to be a data member. Okay. It is similar to our English sentence. Okay, so if I ask how will you frame a sentence in English, what will be your answer? How will you frame your sentence in English? How will you frame a sentence in English or any proper sentence in English? What is your answer? Can you just type in? So I would say like every sentence in English is encapsulated. Okay, can you just type in how will you frame a proper sentence in English? Can you just type in answer like maybe one or two? We don't have time, just type in like whatever comes in your mind, you can just type in. I just want people to be more interactive. Yeah. So I got subject, verb and object. Okay. So in a very shorter term, I can say sentence is nothing but noun and verb. What is noun? It represents person name or person age or person address or anything. It is specifying the characteristics of the person. And what is verb? Any action that performs is said to be verb. So similar to Java, we have two things. So these are noun and these are verb. Okay. So if you have noun and verb in a programming thing, then it is said to be a class. Okay. So noun is nothing but it represents name, age, like that. And verb is nothing but it's like set is on action, get is on action, like that. So this is all about encapsulation. Okay. So now I have created a class called ENC demo. In that I have name, age, and I have method called get name as well as set name. So if I set name, if I set something, the name will be assigned to this and it will be assigned to here. Okay. So now I have just created a class and I just created a data member and member method. So we can call this as data member. All noun is said to be a data member, and these are member method or member functions. Now I'm going to assign a name and I'm going to assign an age and I'm going to print that. Okay. How we can print that? Can you tell me how to create an object in Java? Can you just type in your answer? How will you create an object in Java? Can you just type in your answer? How will you print or how will you create an object in Java? Someone can print this. How will you print or how will you create an object in Java? This is another question, another interview question they will ask. Suppose if I have a class, okay, how will you create an object in Java? Can you just type in your answer? Can anyone type in your answer? So let me check. Are you guys listening? Okay, 44 are there. Okay, can you just type in your answer? Okay. I think no one is interested. Okay, we'll go to the code. Okay, so I have created a class. Now to create an object, I need to just create. Just I need to write a class, then followed by anything like obj or it's like object name. So object env, it's my object name equal to new class name. Then I want to set name. Okay. So for that, we have created setters and getters. Okay. Set is used to assign a value. Get is used to get the value. So what I will do is I will set the name dot set name. I could say keys. Then again, I will use another object, the same object and another method called get age 22. Now I can able to print it. So with the help of system.out.println and so object.setName is for setting the value. Object.getName is for getting the value. Dot getName. So similarly, I can type in the age also. I can get the age also. Now I can able to run it. So I can get both name and age here. Okay. So this whole class is said to be encapsulated. Okay, so if they ask encapsulation, it is nothing but the answer is very straightforward. The process of having data member, okay, and a member method in a single place is called encapsulation. They will ask, can you explain what is encapsulation in Java? Like, where you write encapsulation in Java? So every class in Java is said to be encapsulated. So you can see here the capsule image where this class has the variable as well as method. Okay, the process of having variable as well as method or data member and member methods in a single place is called as encapsulation. Okay, so any doubt in this? Can you just type in your response? Any doubt in this encapsulation? Any doubt? Okay, so now we will have one quiz, okay? Okay, so now the first question, please ready in responding the answer, okay? Okay, what is the initial name of Java? And the first question is, what is the initial name of Java? You can type in your response with your name. What is oak? Oak is nothing but it's a tree, right? It's a tree which was growing in the sun's microsystem laboratory. Okay, the second question is, what is which machine or which component in Java will allow us to perform platform independency? You can type in your name and you can submit. Which component in Java will help you to make platform independent? You can just type in your name and you can submit. Okay, the answer is JVM. Okay. So we'll go to the next topic because we don't have plenty of time, and we'll go for types of methods. Okay. So normally method, what is method is? Method is nothing but it's like a verb or it is like an action. Okay. For example, here, this is a method. So method can have access specifier, then return type of the method and the method. Okay. And if we specify a return type here, we should use the return keyword here. So this method is used to get the name and this method is used to set the name. Likewise, method is of two type. Okay. I will create another package. Okay. So it is like org. incdu method demo. I will create a class called method demo. I will put a public static void main here. Okay, so I have just created a method demo. Okay, I'm going to create a method. So it's like a public void display. Okay, so this is a method without return type. You can see whenever there is a keyword called void, then that particular method is a non-returnable method. Okay, it's like said to be a void method. And whenever you see a method like this, public string, okay, so display one or two. So this method is said to be a method with return type. So if you specify any data type here, then you have to specify return keyword and followed by some value, default value maybe. So if it is a string, you have to just give a string like this. Say you can say like method return type. And for void method, you can just use sysout. You can print like method without return type. So method without return type is said to be a void method. Then This is the method, like I have created two method. This is method with without return type, and this is the method with return type. Now I will create an object for this. So I will create an object. Then I will call this method. So I will call this display method. And I will call this one more method, display. Now if I run this, I will get the response. Okay. So I am getting only one value here, method without return type. So when you run this program, okay, demo.display. So this display will call this method without return type. Okay, it has system.out.println, so it is printing the result. But when you when you call display2, so it is just a return method. It will just return the value, it will not print the value. So to print that, we have to use sysout. System.out.println. So if I run, I will get both of the things. Okay. So there are two types of methods. Okay. One is method with return type and method without return type. So normally in applications, they will go for method with return type. They should not, they will not use the sysout. For example, in my application, no, like we have like thousands and 10,000 lines of 10,000 files will be there. So none of them, like none of the place they will use system.out.println. They will just create a method, they will just return it. Okay. When calling the method, they will use whether they can able to, they want to store the value or they can able to print the value. For example, if you want to store this value, so I can just use like string result to demo.display. Then I will print this result here. So normally people will go for method with return type only. Okay. So the question will be like, what are all the types of methods? Your answer should be like, there are two types of method. One is method with return type and method without return type. So if you have method with return type, you should have return keyword in it. And if you don't have method without return type, you can use anything like you can assign some value or you can use system.out.println. So now we'll go for the next very important topic, static versus non-static methods. Okay. So can you guys type in like what is the purpose of static keyword? Can you guys type in this? I want to see what is your understanding on static keyword and non-static keyword. What is the purpose of static and non-static? I'll give you 1 minute. Like, can you just type in what is the purpose of static keyword? So I think 30 people are there. Can you just type in your response? Okay, used for memory management. Okay, correct. Okay. Yeah, I think someone has given the answer for magic number of Java. Okay, so I will explain it. Okay, so before going to the static method, let's go for one more method. Okay, say it is method like we have a method overloading, right? So here you see display is one method. Okay, and I'm going to create one more method. So public void display, and I'm going to pass some value here. Parameter. I'm going to pass a value here. You see, method is same, display, but the parameter only differs. So here there is no parameter, and here we have only one parameter. Okay, or one parameter. So this is called as method overloading. Okay, this is also another concept we can call that as polymorphism also. Polymorphism is like ability to take multiple form. Here you see display is one method, again another display, but we have extra parameter into it. Okay, so this is called as polymorphism and method overloading. Okay, so the thing is, like, suppose if I call this demo dot display of name, demo of display of name, what it will do is, suppose if I ignore this one, what it will do is it will just check for display method. Okay, so we have two display method here, and but here you see, like, extra parameter you are passing. King is extra parameter, which is of string, so it will just check for this parameter. So there is no parameter, it will ignore. And we have another parameter here, say string. So it will just take this and it will execute this. So the output will be hello name. So you see, hello kings will be there. So if I use this, if I use both, first it will check for display. Okay, display, we have two places. So display, and we are not passing a parameter, so it will go to this method and it will execute this. And again, demo.display kings, it will just check for the display. Display occurs two times and it will pass the parameter here and it will print that particular thing. Okay, likewise, this will go. Okay, so method we have studied, like, there are two types of method: method with return type and method without return type. Okay, so method with return type, you should have a return keyword. Method without return type, you should have like anything like assignment or sysout, like that. Now, how you are calling this method? So display is a method. How you are calling this method? Can you type in your answer? How you are calling this method? So this is said to be a non-static method. Can you tell me how will you call this non-static method? I will show you the code. You can type in the response. How we are calling this non-static method? How you are calling this non-static method? Can you type in the response in the chat or in the Google Docs? How will you call the non-static method? Then we will go for static method. Guys, type in your responses. How will you call a non-static method? Okay, so we get two answer like instance and object name, correct? So we have like this, okay? We have three non-static method. These three non-static methods we can call by creating an object. Okay, first I will create an object, say method demo object equal to new method demo, then method object name dot method name, like that. Suppose I am converting this into a static method. If I convert this into a static method, you can see this demo dot display. Okay, it has some suggestion, like it says that it's non-static like that. Okay, so if it is a static method, you no need to create object itself. You can run directly actually. You see, I just removed that object and I'm just going to run that directly by calling the method. Okay, I just added a static method, static keyword in this method. I'm not creating any object. Okay, the concept is very simple. If you are using a static method, you no need to create any object references for the static method. Okay, so now if I run this, I will get the same result. You see, I'm getting the same result, method without return type. The difference between, we have three methods. The difference between three method is like first method is static method and other two methods are non-static method. So we can call this static method directly with help of method name. So just like that, we can just call like this. Suppose if I convert everything into a static method, I will say how it works. So I'm going to convert this into a static. Okay, so no need to create any object. I'm going to call another thing. So I'm going to run it. I will get the same result. You see, I didn't use any object. Okay, I have not created any object. Okay, so static is nothing but static methods can be called without creating any object. Static is class oriented. You can see within this class, we can able to call the static, and the scope of the static method is within this class. Scope means like you can use this static method within the class. Okay, so that is the main difference. So this is a very important question, like what is static and what is non-static method. Okay, they will ask what is static method. Your answer should be static method is a method, like you don't need to create any instance of a class. You can just like that, you can directly call that method. And the static methods are class oriented, or the scope of the class static methods are within the class, like that. Okay, and we have seen method overloading also. Okay, any doubt up to this? So we have completed like 10 slides. Okay, so if the interview will be like suppose for the fresher, no, the interview, the technical interview, it will be maximum of say 30 minutes. Out of this 30 minutes, like we have completed like say 7 or 8 minutes. Okay, so these are the main questions they will ask in interview. Okay, for fresher. Okay, so any doubt up to this topic, can type in the chat. Yeah, so there is a question like where we will use static and non-static method. Okay, so like I said, so this static method, no, like there will be some application where we don't want to create object but we want to use that method. Okay, that particular case we can go for static method. Like there should not be any I don't want to create object but I want to use those methods, I can just directly go for this methods. And also for object management or memory management, we can able to reduce some memory if we use static method. static method can be like, you know, can be called from different classes also. That we'll see in maybe afternoon session. So there is a thing like exception handling at all. There I will use static. Okay, I will explain that. Any doubt? You can type your thing. Any doubt? I think some of them has sent. Can I create an application only with static? Yeah, we can create application only with the static method. But normally, if you have a scope, you can go for static method. But you can't create an entire application with static method alone. Solomon, can you answer? Can you able to understand all the concepts which we have studied? Solomon, Sundar Singh. Any doubt in static and or any doubt up to this topic? Any doubt? Can you just type in whether you are able to understand, like yes or no, like that? You are able to understand or you are not able to understand, or if you want any other topics to be taken again. Okay, what about Solomon? You have sent smiley. Did you able to understand? Okay. Okay, so now we'll go for next one, constructor. Okay, constructor. What is mean by constructor? So we have seen methods. Okay, we have seen methods. Method with return type, method without return type, and we have seen static method also. Now we'll see constructor, the use of constructor and all with a very small application. Okay, after this Solomon needs to Solomon has to explain me what is constructor and all. Okay, Solomon, be ready. Okay, so I just created one class. Okay, what is constructor? So constructor is nothing but it is similar to a method. Okay, and that method will not return any value. That's all. Constructor is similar to a method that it should not return any value. Okay, and constructor should be same name as a class name, like this. So my class name is constructor demo. So constructor should be same name as a class name, like this. So now I will be typing this thing, public static void main. So again, you see, like in my beginning of the session, I said I will explain the static. Okay, because of the static, we no need to call this public static void main. It will automatically get called. So now this constructor, constructor is a special method which doesn't have, like, you should not have void, or you should not have any string here or any data type here. Constructor is nothing but it's a special member method, a special method without any return type, not even like you should not use void. And what is the purpose of constructor? It is used to initialize value. For example, say I have a string name and int age. Okay, what is the initial value of this name? So I can set name as double quotes. I can set age as 0. So constructor is used to initialize some value. Okay, and next question is, when constructor will be called? So when constructor will be called is, whenever you create an object for this class, the constructor will get called automatically. Whenever you create an object for this class, the constructor will get called automatically. Suppose I just created an object, this constructor will get called automatically, and the name will be assigned to empty string, and the name or age will be assigned to a default 0 value. Okay. And suppose I, so this is constructor. Okay, we have like constructor overloading also, where you have constructor and with arguments. For example, say if I want to pass name. Okay, so say if I want to pass name and if I want to pass age. Okay, what I can do is I can assign a value here, name equal to n and age equal to a, and I can pass the value here, name. Name I can pass, means the age I can pass. Okay, likewise I can pass, and I can create one method to display the value. So public void, sorry, public void display. So I'm going to print both. Ages plus age. Now I can call this method. Dot display. So what it will do is, we have passed a constructor, or we created an object. In that object itself, we are passing kings and 23. So what it will do is, it will check for the constructor. We have two constructor. But you see the parameter is 2 here, and it doesn't have parameter, so it will ignore this one. Okay, then it will go for this parameter, and it assigns kings in name, okay, n, and 23 in a. So this n is assigned to name and this a is assigned to age. Then we will print this with the help of display method. Okay, so now we'll get the result. Okay. So constructor is nothing but, constructor is a special method. Okay, constructor is a special method. Constructor is a special method. Okay, name should be same as class name. It should not return any value. It should not return any value. Okay. So constructor is a special member method, okay, and it should not return anything, and the name should be similar to, or it should be same as the class name. And we have two types of constructors: constructor with parameter and constructor without parameter. Okay, constructor without parameter is said to be a default constructor. So this is said to be a default constructor. Constructor with parameter is said to be a parameterized constructor. How will you call the constructor? When you create object itself, the constructor will be get called. Okay. And one more thing. What is the purpose of this keyword? What is the purpose of this keyword? Can you explain what is the purpose of this keyword? It's a very important interview question. What is the purpose of this keyword? Can you just tell me what is the purpose of this keyword? Can anyone type in like what is the purpose of this keyword? Solomon, can you type what is the purpose of this keyword? What is the purpose of this keyword? Can anyone type in? This is a very important interview question. What is the purpose of this keyword? It's a very important question. type in the answers, everyone. Okay, so to refer the current object in a method. Okay. To initialize the object of a class, okay. Okay, so I will explain. It's a very, very simple thing. Okay, now what I passed is, I passed kings and I passed 23 here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give name and I'm going to give age. So here you see, okay, I'm going to pass this name age. Okay, so here you see the name is a variable name which is there in class, and this name is a parameter for this constructor. I'm assigning name equal to name, age equal to age. Okay, what will be the answer? Can you tell me what will be the answer for this? What is name and what is age? Can anyone tell me? Okay, so without typing, like, can you all unmute your call, and can you guys tell me what is the answer? Can you guys tell me what is the answer? Suppose if I use suppose if I use same variable name for constructor parameter as well as the data member, what will be the answer? What will be the output? Can you guys unmute and tell me what is the answer? Soumya, can you tell me? We'll randomly pick some people and we'll ask. Soumya, or can you tell me? You are there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell me what is the answer for this? Okay, we'll run this. So if I run this, I will get the default name. The default name is null and the default name is age. The reason is, here you see, I'm using name, which is same as the class name. And this is constructor parameter and this is class name. The class data member, which is same. Okay, to avoid this, okay, we have to use this keyword. So this dot name equal to name and this dot age equal to age. If I run this, you'll see. So now you see the value gets assigned. So this specifies the current instance. Suppose they will ask, what is the purpose of this keyword? Where you'll use it? Suppose if I have constructor parameter and class name or class data member are same, we have to use this keyword to specify the current instance. Okay, this has plenty of scope, but in a fresher point of view, the answer for this is, this specifies the current instance. Okay, if you have a constructor name or constructor variable and data member variable are same, we can use this keyword. Okay, so any doubt in this? Any doubt? Can you guys unmute and tell me what any doubt in this constructor? Or you can type in the chat also, because we have like 7 minutes left for break. Okay, the purpose of this keyword I told you, no? The purpose is, okay, that is I typed, right? The purpose, okay. Any doubt? Okay, so one of the colleague, like one of the student, like asked, can we pass optional parameter for a method without using the method overloading? Can you unmute and tell me what is your exact question? What is mean by optional parameter? I will explain. I couldn't understand your question. Can you tell me just, or can you type it in private, like what is your doubt?
Sir, and the if you display in sort of method to create one, அதுல வந்து நேம் சொல்லிட்டு ஒரு வெச்சிருப்போம் அப்ப நம்ம கால் பண்றப்போ நேம் வந்து பாஸ் பண்ணுவோம் انا டிஸ்ப்ளே மெத்தட்ல வந்து நேம் ஏஜ் வெச்சிருக்கேன் انا எனக்கு நேம் மட்டும் தான் பாஸ் பண்ணனும் அப்படி பண்ண முடியுமா
புரியல இந்த क्वेश्चन இந்த புரோகிராம்ல பாத்தீங்கன்னா லைக் மூணு மெத்தட் இருக்கு கரெக்ட்டுங்களா லைக் டிஸ்ப்ளே ஒரு மெத்தட் டிஸ்ப்ளே மெத்தட்ல பாராமீட்டர் இல்ல டிஸ்ப்ளே மெத்தட்ல ஒரு பாராமீட்டர் இருக்கு டிஸ்ப்ளே 2ன்ற மெத்தட்ல பாராமீட்டர் இல்ல உங்களுக்கு எதை பாஸ் பண்ணனும்
இப்போ டிஸ்ப்ளே மெத்தட்ல நேம் மட்டும் பாஸ் பண்ணிருப்போம்ல சார்
ஆமா
இப்போ அதுல வந்து நான் நேம் கூட ஆப்ஷனலா ஏஜும் பாஸ் பண்ண முடியுமா அந்த மாதிரி கேக்குறாங்க
ஆப்ஷனலா இது எக்ஸ்ட்ரா இன்னொரு பாராமீட்டர் நீங்க கேக்குறீங்களா
ஆ இது கூட இன்னொரு ஒரு பாராமீட்டர் انا
ஆப்ஷனலா ஆட் பண்ற பாத்தீங்களா இது நான் ஏஜும் கொடுத்திருக்கேன் பட் அப்படி நீங்க கொடுத்தீங்க அப்படினா நீங்க இந்த ரெண்டு பாராமீட்டர் கீழ எங்கயாவது பாஸ் பண்ணனும் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இங்க வந்து நான் ஏஜ் 15 னு பாஸ் பண்ணனும் இப்ப நான் ஆப்ஷனலா நம்ம வைக்க கூடாது இப்படி நான் வச்சேன் அப்படின்னா என்ன ஆகும்னா இந்த டிஸ்பிளே மெத்தட் இங்க இருக்கான்னு பாக்கும் இங்க இல்ல ஏன்னா இதுல வந்து நான் ஒரு பாராமீட்டர் பாஸ் பண்ணிருக்கேன் ரெண்டாவது மெத்தட் பாக்கும் இதுல பாத்தீங்கன்னா ரெண்டு பாராமீட்டர் பாஸ் பண்ணிருக்கேன் ஆனா ஒரே ஒரு பாராமீட்டர் தான் நான் அனுப்பியிருக்கேன் சரிங்களா சோ அப்போ வந்து என்ன சொல்லுவோம் கம்பைல இஷ்யூ வரும் என்ன இஷ்யூ வரும்னா நீ வந்து ஒரு பாராமீட்டர் பாஸ் பண்ணிருக்க ஆனா வந்து எனக்கு ஒரு பாராமீட்டர் மாதிரி எனக்கு இங்க வேல்யூவே இல்ல அப்படின்னு சொல்லி அது கொடுக்கும் அதுக்கு பதிலா நம்ம என்ன பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்னா இன்னொரு மெத்தட் ஒன்னு கிரியேட் பண்ணிக்கோ இப்படி நீங்க கொடுத்துட்டீங்க அப்படின்னா நான் வந்து ஏஜ் வந்து ஆப்ஷனல் புரியுதா இப்ப நான் வந்து ஏஜ் அனுப்பல நான் ஸ்ட்ரிங் தான் அனுப்புறேன் அப்படின்னா என்கிட்ட மூணு மெத்தட் இருக்கு ஸோ இந்த மூணு மெத்தட்ல இது ஜஸ்ட் செக் பண்ணும் இதுல எங்க ஒரு பேராமீட்டர் இருக்குன்னு ஸோ இங்க ஒரு பேராமீட்டருமே இல்லை இங்க ரெண்டு பேராமீட்டர் இருக்கு இங்க வந்து ஒரு பேராமீட்டர் இருக்கு ஸோ இது கால் ஆகும் ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி ஆப்ஷனலா வைக்கணும்னா ஜஸ்ட் இன்னொரு மெத்தட் கிரியேட் பண்ணிட்டு அந்த செகண்ட் பாராமீட்டர் மட்டும் ரிமூவ் பண்ணிடு புரியுதா
ஓகே சார்
ஓகே வேற ஏதாவது டவுட் இருக்கா எனி அதர் டவுட்ஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் வி வில் ஹேவ் இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் இன்டர்ஃபேஸ் அப்ஸ்ட்ராக்ட் கிளாஸ் எக்ஸப்ஷன் ஹேண்ட்லிங் தட்ஸ் ஆல் ஓகே வி ஹேவ் லாஸ்ட் 4 மினிட்ஸ் ஃபார் தி பிரேக் ஓகே So up to this, we have any doubt? இதுல ஏதாவது டவுட் இருக்கா சொல்லி கொடுத்த வரைக்க இது வரைக்கும் ஏதாவது டவுட் இருக்கா ஓகே நோ ஓகே சோ வி ஹாவ் லைக் 4 மினிட்ஸ் லைக் கேன் யூ ஆல் அன்மியூட் யுவர் மீட்டிங் So we'll ask some different, like I will ask questions, we'll just see whether we can able to answer it or not. Okay, I'll unmute pannunga paakala. Solomon, unmute pannu paakala, pesala avangitta, summa edha pesum. Last 3 nimisham irukku nammalku. Solomon, unmute pannunga, ungala pathi edha sollunga. சோலமன் இருக்காரா சோலமன் சுந்தர் சிங் ஆர் சோலமன் இருக்கீங்களே ஏதாவது பேசுங்க சும்மா என்ன படிக்கிறீங்க என்ன உங்களோட ஆம்பிஷன் சும்மா ஏதாவது சொல்லுங்க பாப்போம் ஓகே அவர் எங்கேயோ போயிட்டாரு போல ஓகே ஃபைன் சோ இது வரைக்கும் ஏதாவது புரிஞ்சுதா உங்களுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் ஏதாவது புரிஞ்சுதா எல்லாம் அன்மியூட் பண்ணி சொல்லுங்க பாக்கலாம் ஜான்சன் சொல்லுங்க ஜான்சன் சௌமியா ஜெயசூர்யா
சார் புரிஞ்சுது சார்
ஓகே ஃபாஸ்டா போகணுமா இல்ல ஏதாவது ஸ்லோவா போகணுமா ஆஃப்டர்நூன் செஷன் இல்ல ஏதாவது எக்ஸ்ட்ரா டாபிக் எடுக்கணுமா
சரி இதே லெவல்ல போனா போதும்.
ஓகே ஓகே. யோகேஸ்வரி சொல்லுங்க எப்படி போலாம் நம்ம, புரிஞ்சுதா உங்களுக்கு? ஓகே சாலமன் சுந்தர் சிங் லெஃப்ட், சூப்பர். ஓகே சோ ஜஸ்ட் வில் ரிவைஸ் லாஸ்ட் 2 மினிட்ஸ் தேர். இப்ப காலையில என்ன பார்த்தோம் அப்படின்னா, வி ஸ்டடிட் வாட் இஸ் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் இண்டிபெண்டன்ட், வார்ம் பார்த்தோம், ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஜாவா பார்த்தோம், ஸோ பேசிக் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் பார்த்தோம், கிளாஸ் எப்படி கிரியேட் பண்றது, ஆப்ஜெக்ட் எப்படி கிரியேட் பண்றது, மேஜிக் நம்பர் பார்த்தோம், மேஜிக் நம்பர் வந்து கேஸ் பேம். இதை நீங்க வந்து யார்கிட்ட வேணா கேட்கலாம், மேஜிக் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஜாவா சொல்லுங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு, யாருமே சொல்ல மாட்டேன், யாருக்குமே இந்த ஆன்சர் தெரியும். தென் என்கேப்சுலேஷன், தென் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் மெத்தட்ஸ், தென் ஸ்டாட்டிக் அண்ட் நான் ஸ்டாட்டிக். ஸ்டாட்டிக் மெத்தட்னா ஒன்றும் இல்லை, நம்ம ஆப்ஜெக்டே கிரியேட் பண்ண தேவை, அந்த மெத்தடை டைரெக்டா கால் பண்ணலாம், ஸ்டாட்டிக் மெத்தட். மெத்தட் ஓவர்லோடிங்னா ஒரே மெத்தடு வேற வேற பேராமீட்டர் வச்சு பாஸ் பண்ணலாம். கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டர்னா ஒரு ஸ்பெஷல் மெம்பர் மெத்தட், ஆர் ஸ்பெஷல் மெத்தட், அது எதையும் ரிட்டர்ன் பண்ணாது, அது நம்மளுக்கு வேல்யூ அசைன் பண்ணலாம். இனிஷியலா டிஃபால்ட் வேல்யூ நம்ம அசைன் பண்ணலாம் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டர்ல. அதுக்கப்புறம் வந்து கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டர் வந்து லைக் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டர்ல நிறைய டைப் இருக்கு. கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டர் கூட பேராமீட்டர் போட்டு அனுப்பலாம், கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டர் கூட பேராமீட்டர் இல்லாமல் அனுப்பலாம். இப்ப கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டரோட பேராமீட்டரும் கிளாஸ் டேட்டா மெம்பரோட பேராமீட்டரும் சேமா இருந்துச்சுன்னா நம்ம திஸ் கீவேர்ட் யூஸ் பண்ணி அந்த இஷ்யூவை ரிசால்வ் பண்ணுவோம். சப்போஸ் திஸ் கீவேர்ட் யூஸ் பண்ணலாம்னா அது டிஃபால்ட் வேல்யூ இருக்கு. ஓகே சோ பிரேக் டைம், so we will meet at 1:30. yeah break epa ma'am break epa mudiyum break
sir 1:30.
ah okay so 1:30 meet pannu, bye.
okay.